Senator, the place of Washington State on the global stage, that's where we're here at the Global Washington Conference. Does Washington State truly have a place on the global stage?
You know, we are, of course, the most trade-dependent state in the nation. But outside of just the pure economics of it, there's a social, there's an emotional, there's a spiritual, there's a workforce component to it. We are so integrated in our global community. I think people are familiar, of course, that we're the global leader in planes and coffee and internet and software. They don't really understand the depth and the magnitude and the passion around global development and the role that we play, not only Puget Sound, but our entire state. And that integration and the sense of conviction that so many of the organizations in our state engage in is central to everything we do. And our state government is really engaged in those relationships as well. So it's a very unique place on every level.
Yeah, and interestingly enough, trade became a big issue in the recent presidential election here in the United States. Are there negatives as well as positives to being so trade dependent?
Yeah. You know, well, we have to keep in mind of what we're trading. We're not only selling airplanes and software to the world, but we're selling apples. We're selling agriculture goods. And our agriculture feeds the world. And the Port of Seattle, for example, is the distribution point. It's the portal to the world. We're a day closer to Asia by ship than they are in California. So we're so deeply ingrained in trade. I do think that there's an understanding that, that trade agreements have to be responsible and they have to recognize the effect on the environment and on jobs. But at the same time, our connectedness is so visceral and so real and so expansiveness that I think the people of our state believe overwhelmingly that trade is very much a positive.
And what is the geographic area of the district that you represent?
So I represent Northwest Seattle, which is from Belltown, Queen Anne, Magnolia, Ballard, Greenwood, South Lake Union, all the way up through north part of Seattle.
Many years ago, people would say, yeah, sure, you betcha, but now it's a pretty diverse place.
Diverse place, that's right.
From the trade standpoint, here at the conference, the theme is about alliances, about partnerships, especially between NGOs and the for-profit sector.
That's right.
How does that fit into Washington State?
You know, it fits directly in. I bet you that so many of the companies that are headquartered here in Seattle or prominent in Washington State are more aware of the Millennium Development Goals, the Millennial Development Goals from the United Nations, than almost any other series of companies or organizations in the world. So we have that concentrated sense of ownership and engagement in global development that is so real, that's playing out. You look at some of the organizations that people may not be familiar with, Malaria No More, and their prominent role here in Seattle. And it's not just the Gates Foundation, it's not just PATH, it's so many more small organizations and consultants and advisory groups and law firms and strategic business development support, as well as the public sector. So playing that central role is really powerful.
It's so interesting that you would say that, because when I first moved here 24 years ago, there was something different. There was something global in the mindset of the people. Why is that?
Yeah. Well, I mean, look at that spirit of innovation. We are the driver of innovation in software, in mobile technology, in startups, and in coffee, in so many categories. But there's a human value, a social value, a moral connectedness that the people who live here have to their organizations. And whether those organizations are for-profit or non-profit, there's a connectedness. And those relationships, are represented by Global Washington. That globalization, that international connectedness is very real. So the people who do that work, whether they work at Starbucks or Amazon or Microsoft or PATH or Gates Foundation, have a sense of obligation and connectedness to their own families, their own communities, and to the global community.
Senator, let's look 3 to 5 years out in the future. How is it going to be? How is Washington State going to fare over the next 3 to 5 years on the global stage?
Well, I would make the case that as the federal government potentially retreats from a sense of embracing internationalism, that it is more imperative than ever that Washington State lead. Our relationships with China are unique. Our relationships with Japan are unique. Our relationships with Canada and the growing development relationships with Africa and so many of the individual countries. The East Congo Initiative, which has a central ingredient of its leadership here in Seattle. There's so many initiatives that go to a deeper level of that connectedness. So Washington State is central, and we're not retreating from embracing internationalism in any way. And in fact, we're doubling down and leaning in.
Senator, thank you very much
for being with us. My pleasure. Thank you.